sun, searching for a longer day. People feeling like the light has just come. We must never stop the way. Yeah. Birds jumping and I hear my name, grasping into a life. Life is happy but it's so insane. We must merely make a start. Savannah, I'm coming home. Savannah, we'll never be alone. Savannah, the beauty of the world. Savannah, let's all take a ride. Savannah.
The birds have just begun.
We will always take a stand for the people, for the land. Let's go back to when we were young. For the animals we stand. Let's go back to when trees were swung. Savannah, I'm coming home. Savannah,
say what you want to say to me now. She's not working for you. She's working for herself.
for our personal growth. There are those who say you leave work if you're working. And it, yes, you at the go Modokomera. Modokomera is sour. But she also needs to have a life.
Hmm.
Marriage is not a place of diminishing ourselves, it's a place of growth.
Yes.
We come together so that we are better together.
Hmm.
We ought to grow together.
Hmm.
So it's a place of multiplication. That is why people have children, because children are a miniature of the both of you. You are sending you are sending yourself into the future you will never get to, through the children. You get children so that when, how old do we hope to get? I can see people here maybe in their 30s. So, Mungu akupatie mahida, 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 maiki, maiki. Unafikiria unaweza ishi mpaka lini? Tufanye hiyo hesabu. Mahida, maiki, maiki. Piga duru kabisa. Hata kama amekuita kidogo, piga duru kabisa watu wajue huku kuna shida. Unarudi pigia. By your noise. Please don't be hit, keep it quiet. Ati mtu anakugonga, kesho anakugonga. And if you're not married, for those who are here and they're not married, and a man bangs tables during your courtship, wait for trouble.
Mm.
Walk away. And anaongelesha mtu wa hoteli anamshika shati. Sio wewe ameshika shati. Ameshika mtu mwingine shati kwa ni tuzi ya courtship. Walk away.
Yes.
Sasa will hit you.
Yeah. Yes.
He will hit you when you are in his house and there is nothing you can do.
Yeah.
What does it feel?
Amen.
Why, man? Why would you want to hit a woman? Upigane na kijana na mwanaume saizi yako uogwe vizuri ukuje nyumbani uangaliwe ule uone. That is me, for me, that's where my line draws. If a man hits you, walk away.
Yes.
For the sake of, hata kama ni kwenda kukaa mbali kidogo, kwanza mjue vile mtakaa. If he hits you, just stay away, because you are better alive.
Yes.
You are better when you are not made. And you cannot ever, even if a man is smaller than you in size, ngumi yake ni ya mwanaume.
Yes.
Go and ensure that you take care of him. He is your man. He's come home to you. He could have spent the night in a hotel, but he came home in all his fatigue. Validate him. Let him feel validated. This is my home. When I call in the middle of the night, they come running. She is my wife. It may look small. Maybe for a woman, you feel like you're giving too much. But that is your role. You're not diminishing yourself by giving that. You don't need to be validated. No woman needs to be validated. No one. No woman needs to be validated. God created them in such ability to do so much. And it is okay. It's life. The life moves on. Akona mtoto hapa, akona mwingine hapa, akona kazi ya kanisa, akona kazi yao ya shule, akona CBC, akona. And she's okay. She is never tired, but it is okay. She doesn't need to be bad. But for the man, akifanya kitu dogo mubadide, akinunua gari kuja kuangalia.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. Unajua kuchagua. Validate him. Yeah, usiseme, ndio ulipata. Kwani ukupata kazi kina? Validate him. The other thing a man needs good food.
Yes, the way to a man's stomach.
Cool food. Ukikataa kupika vizuri, anakula huko, anakuja kujazilia kwako. Na kidogo, wakati mwingine atajaza. Mako sawa. Good
food.
Learn how to cook. Yes. Na wale mko na wasichana wa kazi, be very careful. That girl. Yeah. Huyo msichana ndiye ako nyumbani, si ndio?
Yes.
Na wewe usijui uko wapi. Uko na customer wa mwisho saa 4 na saa 5 ya usiku. Anagoja. Basi niwekewe chakula. Kale kasichana umeajiri kwa nyumba yako is half. Sabuni yako.
Shower gels.
Amekula chakula yako green to green. Wewe ukikula Atakula nyama, eh? Unakula tu hili tu mwisho. Yeye amekula nyama ilikuwa mzuri. Ile ya juu, top layer. So, kana kaka zuri tu, wewe umechoka uko na sweat, sijui unakasirika, uko na madeni, uko sijui wapi. So, hata ukioga mafuta haishiki, juu uko na mashida. Kana kasema kana shida. Kana kulala kwako, kana uwaga kwako. Kana lala kwako.
Yes.
Ile mshahara unakapea ya kujipodoa. Mke yake.
Wake up.
And then kana pepeche kwa. Takula nini? Let me tell you, even if you cannot go home, because I know sometimes you will not be able to go home, ensure that at least you can share a meal a day. If you are around, if you are in the same place, share one meal together. Munakula pamoja. It is a place of sharing. Niye pahali ya kukula pamoja. So that even you can see what your husband doesn't like. So that you can cook for him. And then if food is common and you are at home, ingia kwa hiyo kitchen. Angalia ile chakula imepikwa. Usitumanie mtu mwanako akuwekee chakula hata kama ni mtoto wako. Eh? Yule msichana mkubwa ambaye unatumana. Sio bwanake. Huyu mwanamume ako na bwana bibi mmoja katika hii boma. Hata kama kuna wasichana. Wewe mwenyewe enda kio kitchen. If the food is not good to your husband's expectation, you can recook or put something. Weka viungo. Yeah, it is the same food, but went up viungo. And then, for God's sake, serve your man.
Yes.
Serve your man. It is a good place of bonding. Yeah. Serve your man. A man loves his food. Yes. And by the way, when I talk about his good food, he can eat ugali madodo because yule msichana wa kioski, biadioski, anamuongeleshaga vizuri. Are you aware of that? That a man will eat ugali madodo ya 50 bob. Na siku kosa. Kwa sababu yu msichana ako hapo. Anamuza, hey sasa, mshindaji, ukuboa. Nile ni kumete yutu ya kawaida. Nita kuongezea. Imagine, kwa hili yutu. Ugali madodo inaikia kwa mwili haraka sana na inasika ikiwa mzuri. Kwa hili yo. You want to tell me you cannot speak to that man?
We can.
You can. Treat him like a king.
Oh yes.
A man loves his good food served in a nice way. Most men go to drink one beer because there is like a girl at the bar who speaks nicely. Yeah, Chiro? Chiro speaks nicely. You make a sirika. So, and you take two. Yeah, niku, apitia kipa kwa sababu anapenda kukunywa sana. It is the girl at the bar. That good speaking because he likes his nice food served well.
Yes.
Usipatie mashakura kwa sababu wengine wanakula mashakura. Let him serve it nicely, look at it and ensure that it is palatable to him. Those are two things. The other thing that a man likes is companionship. Asubuhi tulisema, every man needs a
helper. Yes.
So a man needs his companion. And his companion preferably being his wife. If he calls you to go somewhere, go. It is not every day he will call you. If he doesn't, if he calls you and you don't go, somebody will sit at your seat. That's your mwanaume. If he calls you, there are times he doesn't call you. But if he says he wants to go with you and you're not available, he wanted a companion. So, and there are many people here who want to show up as companions of your husband because you are treating them now, you are cooking for them nicely, they are looking good, more attractive than a bachelor. Please understand that so that you can keep, you can pray and put a hedge of fire around your man. In Jesus' mighty name, muombe. A married man is more attractive than an unmarried man. This man has been tamed. Ametemiwa, anatoaga pesa haraka, hanaga shida ya kutoa pesa, jukwake ya mezoea kutoa pesa. He's been harassed so like left and center. All the rough edges have been... They have been finished. They are smoothened into nothing. So harassed, so nagged. That is, you are better than my wife. Not yet. Yes, they said, "Wanye nini gira unataka?"
Mm,
so harassed. He knows how to be harassed. A married man is so attractive. So, please, you have a man at home, take care of him.
Yes, please.
He is rare gold.
Mm.
What else, Sophia?
Are we together?
So he needs a companion. If he wants to watch football, can I have water? Come on, it's a man. Since you see, come on, you took a shoulder, Rama Pema. Can I have on a yes? Big yet, in your my yes, yes, yes.
Goal.
Companionship. Stay with him.
Mm.
When he comes home, just stay with him. He has come home, stay with him for some time. He needs you. You are his guy. You're the one who brings sobriety in his life. My shaki kata kushi anakuja home. Anakuja nyumbani kwako. He is coming home to you.
Yes.
And when he gets home, you're so busy. You're doing what? Ukisha mtengenezea chai. Kama yeye hapa atakama ukunywe. Companionship is important. Finally, a man needs sex. As simple as that. Maratatu, maratatu. Not yet. That for a man, sex is a physical need. For women, sex is not a physical need.
Mm.
So you have no idea understanding what I'm saying. But for a man, sex is a physical
need.
Now this is where I was saying about sharing. That is why this topic is about sharing. That there is something you have for him which you don't need.
Mm-hmm.
But as first son.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Now comes in.
Mm.
He has a physical need called sex.
Mm.
Physical. Meaning that he needs it for to go on with his life. Mm? He will need to release however he releases. So it is a physical need. Now I'm going to sit you and check. You couldn't have that one. Yeah, even Pastor Gladys is saying. Sex itself is therapy.
Yes.
It's a kupona. It's an aphrodisiac. It's a kupona pedicure. To zero it. So a man needs sex. If you want, you know your man. If you want in the morning when you're going to church, wake up earlier. Wacha kusema kwamba ati ninaenda kanisa. If that is the time, you act. Jipange maisha yako. No, don't say, oh, I'm tired. Oga, upone, ukwe mzuri. When you get to bed, stop going to bed like you live alone. You don't live alone. Your bed si yako peke yako. Somebody else stays in that bed with you. Usiende kama umeweka.
Sengenge ni ngombe.
Kwanza uko na full neck ati kuna baridi. Kuna baridi na unakaa na mtu. What is wrong with you? Unasikia baridi na kuna mtu kwa hiyo kitanda. Ili uko na duvet tano na full neck unanuka sweat. My God. You should be not be so dressed when you're in bed. What for?
Amen.
As a lady, why are you overdressed in bed? You will just cause trouble. You are overdressed, so by the time layers come at ano, zina toka zote. Watu wamechoka kukoja. What for? What are they for? Si unaenda bed na ulali peke yako. The time you sleep alone, it's okay. Wewe lala na gunia zako. But if you don't sleep alone in that bed, unalala na gunia za kufanya. Remove the gunias. You should be as carefully dressed as possible. Because this man will need sex. It is part of his needs. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Tuko pamoja?
Yes.
Usiseme umekasirika, usiseme umegojeka, usiseme nini. In fact, obey your sex. Let's go back there. How many people pray for their sex? How many? Eh, unafikiria kama mambo yatafanyika na
mnajua haitaki.
You're not praying for it. You're praying for everything as Mungu utupatie magari sita. Bwana tunaomba gari zile kubwa kubwa Jehovah katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Then you're not praying for the basics. Sex is a basic. Pray for lead. If you don't like it, pray. Pia Mungu wewe ndio unapeanaga nguvu. Kuja sasa mimi kwa yangu Jehovah. Mimi nakuhitaji.
Libido.
Nimemaliza what I'm saying. Let's talk about what I'm saying.
Yes, please.
Her mind is like that. You see the way her heart is?
Yes.
That's how her mind is. Everything is put together. I need pen, serviette, ete. Wet wipes, ete. Sabun, ete. Here too, ete. Do the best just in case I don't come home back, ete. Shuka igine, ete. Nini igine. An extra blouse, ete. Kio, ete. Apa na the sex, yo. Tishu muzima, weka.
Lotion.
Lotion, yes. Ah, the whole vanity box, yote. Lete weka hapa. Lete hapa. Fukuo za nyumba yote na ziko na zikine na pairs zote. Kopes kama tatu na fukuo the same ziko. Lete. Bible weka hapa. Karamu kama tatu. Amesahau hata zikine ziko hapo. Weka. Kababe, kababe. Akona simu na akona kababe. Kababe, weka hapa. Hey, okay, hey. My coins are to me. That's at the one drop. Where can you get that? Why you sit on that? So, at the end of the day, that's how woman's mind. So, when she comes home, she wants to remove them and arrange them nicely. So, when she's talking to you as a man, please stop giving solutions. She's not looking for solutions for me. She really knows exactly what she wants to do. You are just the place where she removes. Ni kama kuwakia mtu lala ni kumwagidia mtu za kuzote ni chipande kuzuri. Lala! Wewe man, lala! Lala hapo! So the man is like, na kina taku na unahanja kuwana nini wewe lala. Wewe, you are my place of putting all my nonsense. I want to rearrange them. So as a man, sit slowly, accept for that woman to unwind through you. Give solutions. Even when she asks, what do you think I should do? Muliza, unaona aje wewe. She already knows exactly what she wants to do. Yeah, she has made it, she has, her mind is working like that. All she wants is somebody to know it matters to you. That's all she wants. Yeah. That she matters to you the way she is. If you are living with her here, she is important to you. That is important. The other thing that a woman needs, said about three things. The other thing a woman needs is what I talked about in the morning, it's called security. A woman follows a man whom she thinks will make her secure. In all ways. That is why a woman will insist on marriage. Wedding, ya kanisa. Men ask what for? It is because she wants security. A woman comes and chooses a man. Let me tell you, this is how it happens. Even if the women sometimes look civilized and they are not like the one who chose the men. They actually knew this is a man who can make a good father. When a woman is getting married, ask a man what he wants when he's good getting married. Mwanaume akioa anahitajaga vitu vingi. Hizo zingine za kujaga baadaye. Anataka chakula na sex. Mwanaume akioa ni kuna vitu vingine. Hizo tu ndizo vitu anataka saa hiyo. At that moment. And it's just the way it is. For a woman, the first thing she wants is security. She wants to be sure this man can take care of my children. Ameona mbali. Hata kama hujafika hapo. She is so sure of herself that me and this man together, whatever is there, she knows that. So, from you, from a man, what does that woman want? Security. Ya kwamba akienda kupata mtoto. Na wewe hautakuwa unaruka ruka sijui wapi unatafuta hali ya bana. She wants, she's going to give birth to your child. and you are making her life miserable. Now that is insecurity. And she will feel, she may not leave, but she is like, I'm done with you. I never thought about it, but I'm done. Why? Because she wants security. A woman wants security, that is why a man should provide. Because provision, finances, money, besha, is the greatest form of security that a woman needs. Do not say that women are not gold diggers, they are. But they dig the gold. So give them credit. The gold was so hugo. And you know they do over here, Jehovah. Either to that dig, we will get it. She is a gold digger with no apology. Yeah. But when she digs her gold, give it to her. You cannot. How is it called? Gold in a digiwa na umeperekea mwingine mwenye haku dig gold.
Yes, please.
You see, that is my man.
My man is my man.
I can look beautiful for him. Yeah, because he had given me beautiful for this man.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Mm. Even if she does so many things, because women have the ability to do so many things. Even after she does so many things, she remembers there is a man who has provided my security. Therefore, I am going to be beautiful for this man. Whatever he needs, I will give. Ya mwisho, for today, you can go and check on us. For today, is a woman needs touch.
Oh.
Touch.
Record.
Most of the time, when men want sex, women want touch. But along the way, kila mtu anasaidika huko. But a woman does not, most of the time, they're not wanting sex. They are wanting touch. That kind of. That's why you always talk na huko for a man. How you jaongea hu na huko? How you jamsalimia? How you kumhag? Ulipoingia kwa nyumba? How you kumhag? You didn't even ask how her day was. There was no touch. And then in the middle of the night, ukiamuka after kulala for 6 hours. Unatana. She will feel offended. You have not touched her, and immediately after sex, you run na huko kwingine na unaangalia na huko. What do you think? That is very unfair. Bwana sikuwe, women sikuwe pia hawa watu.
Yes!
It is totally unfair. She wants touch.
Yes.
Actually, a woman is not in need of sex because for her, for men, sex is physical. A woman needs the emotional attachment. How does the emotional attachment come? Through touch. Touch her. Hold her. Hug her. Touch her hand. Pass through the kitchen. Put your hand on her shoulder. Those small things. Eh. Pat her. Touch, 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 touch. In the morning before you leave, hold her. It may be a small hand, but it is important. She will stay with that hand and that touch for the whole day.
Yes.
When you come home, look for her first. Hold her nicely the way you hold your three, your two. Just think about that baby and that girl. So hold her nicely. You see the way you hold your 2-year-old? What does it feel? You say you're not 2-year-old, you're not daddy! It is only that your wife cannot run like that, but she wants exactly to do that. Exactly what she wants. And I don't have to be a boy. You say you want to scare her. Bride and a kasirika tika usi ni bebe. Usi ni skia tika bride and a kasirika. Wakati wa usi ni bebe. Usi ni bebe. She doesn't mean it. She want to be carried.
She wants to be carried.
She want to be carried. It is only that. Squeezy. Wanaume na wanaka inaitanaga bae. But the bae is a word for your girl. She's the only one who can be your baby. Carry her, hold her. She wants the touch. She cannot say it because she's big with 3 children, but she wants it anyway. Hold her, and let her know she is your woman. Your world stops around her. She will give you what you want.
Yes.
I'm just a girl.
Yes.
The video to the kingdom is to go. Gone wrong.
Yes.
Order. The order has already, something has happened. So, first, know where have you not, in the order, have you provided? Have you done the things that you should have done? Probably she is bitter. Why is she bitter? I like it koneke. Rora kalia tena. She's mad. So you will need a lot of undoing that you have done. Kuna a lady you can tell ali atoke sini kwa di kwa kwa kwa. I want you need a minute to dear usiku cha hapa kunisikiliza au nikataa kunisikiza. She is throwing tantrums because she keep on doing what you're doing. One day she will just say, hey, I think the man has changed. And she will become the girl you want her to be. Soft on the edges. There's no man who wants a hard woman. Eh? A woman is like a man in the house. Ata ukiongea uki. Yeah, unaongea kama mwanaume. Eh? Because you're so hardened. Every woman, man wants a woman who is soft on the edges. But of course, life... Hardened women.
Yes.
Been there, done that. So we are over here. At the same time, you come here and provide. So how? Softness. If she is providing, but softness is gone.
Amen.
Go back to the order.
Yes.
If she is throwing tantrums, go back to the order. Something has gone wrong. I want to say the last thing. The Garden of Eden. re-energized, redefined, recreated is a place of play. Play. Mchezo, furaha, not being so serious.
Hey.
Have you thought of your wife or your husband as your best friend?
You're my best friend.
Yeah, are you friends with him? Ni party ya validation, kucheka na jokes zake. Na hata ujasisikia. Lakini unachotexi mami. Hata ujafraia laki. Let me tell you for the guys. I don't know whether there are people who are not married. If a girl cannot laugh at your joke, walk away.
Run for your life. Run, Maurice.
It's true. That's how it starts. Wow. She needs to think you are the igwe. If she doesn't think you are igwe, if you don't impress her from the one, sahau. If mukigia kwa hoteli anajiripia chakula, sahau. She's not your girl. She belongs to someone else who can pay her bills. She's not your class. Tafuta a girl you can mesmerize. Unaweza peleka KICC kaseme, guy! It is true. If you cannot wow that girl, she's not yours.
Yes.
From day one, you need to wow that girl. She's saying, she needs to be taken to Mombasa by you. The very first time. And you need to quit. Agaria is the place. Agaria, usikuwe unaingia kwa feri nini ndio unasema haya haya kaenda kwa hiyo. Without feeling like you're being exposed. Sasawa? Yeah. You can oversleep. You can. You don't have to wonder how you wake up looking like, because this person loves you anyway. It's a place of play. And at the place of play, you need to know the love languages. People have different love languages. They are actually fine. Kuna watu wanapenda kupewa gift. Kuna watu wanapenda words of affirmation. Kuna watu wanapenda gift. Kuna watu wanapenda words of affirmation. Kuna watu wanapenda touch.
Physical touch.
Kuna watu hiyo ndio their love language. Si kusema wasichana wote wapendi touch, lakini kuna wale wanapenda sana. Niko wengine. So, kuna watu wanapenda touch, they are fine. Let me see the other two. Kuna watu wanazijua,
Act of service.
Action and quality time. Kuna watu wanapenda ukae na wao. Na si kusema wanaume wapendi companionship, wote wanapenda, lakini kuna wale wanapenda sana quality time. Kuna quality time, kuna act, kufanyiwa kawodo, kuna gift, kuna mtu anataka umtengeneze bag, toka hiyo siku anakupenda sana. But by the way, a girl should not know how kutengeneza bag kama kuna mtu kwa nyumba. How? Alipanda huko akifanya nini? The man was not available. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Yes. So that is what it is, a place of play. It should be a place of enjoyment, a place of love, a place of ease, a place of knowing each other's love language. Ndio watu wasikosanie huko. Pengine wewe unapenda gift, and your wife anapenda touch. So umemletea maua, ameiweka hapo, hata haja kumbuka kuweka maji na wewe umekasirika. Na yeye alikuwa anataka tu hug. Na wewe ujui, learn your love languages. Love languages are different. Learn them. They are fine. You can check them and listen to one. Hallelujah. So I am done. Needs to talk to you. If she is not talking to you, if she is not that nagging, she has moved on somewhere in a certain way. And for men think it's okay. It is not okay. It means that she has gotten a place elsewhere where she is getting that satisfaction of being listened to. And sometimes when a man, the man is needs to understand that if how his woman is okay, if she needs, he needs to understand that kienda kutafuta, sometimes unatafuta unakosa kwa sababu your woman is not okay. Sisi kama nime, yani, why are you struggling? Why are you having issues? Za kazi, tulisema mambo ya neno liko katika pita. Yani, when she is unhappy, your prayers, inajua na siyo lazima ikuwa ni maombi wa Mungu tenda. Inaweza kuwa ni kufungua hiyo duka, that's your maombi yako, sindio? Maombi yako. Why are your prayers not being, why are you struggling in the first place? Why are you so busy that you have no time? Why are you so busy? Why are you angry? Because a man will not be off sex because of three things. One, when he is stressed. Stress. Three things for women to get this. When a man is off sex for three things. Stress, or sick, or another woman.
Yes.
Those three things. He is either stressed. So as a man, why are you stressed? Because she is unhappy. It's a cycle. For you to be happy, she needs to be happy. When she is happy, it means you are not stressed. You are not stressed because you got a deni nini nini. Because ukiwa na stress, unakosa haja ya sex. Na hata ukikuwa hapo, ni kupitia. So first and foremost, understand. She is so important to you that you need to take time to do the things she thinks that are not important so that you can ease on the stress. Stress iko kwa sababu she is unhappy. So when she is happy, you will find your life is easier, even as a man. Ile mambo unafikiria ya kwamba ni kupitia tu. So she is, then when she is even unhappy in sex, it is very easy to shut. By the way, men should be very careful. A lady asifike mahali ya kusema sita kisi na haja. When she feels hana haja, your society akusubua zaidi, because the day you want, she will have sex with you in a very bad way. Yani ataona umepitia na mutasumbuana. So, ataachwa na bitterness. Unajua kuna vile watu mtu anaachwa na machungu. She has had sex, but she is very bitter. She feels used. She actually feels, hapo ndio watu wanaongea mambo ya rape in marriage. Whereby a woman feels, rape does not necessarily mean ulimshika ko. No, it means that she feels used. So for a man, know that it starts with you, you are the head. So that you don't have to stay, to feel like you don't want, take time and take your love.
Y se me cae.